Hi, Johnny here, and welcome to Birdland. Thank you for tuning in, and happy holidays. For the last 3 months, we've had the honor of hosting one of the world's greatest orchestras. Please help me welcome the Afro Latin Jazz Orchestra, directed by Arturo O'Farrill.
Thank you. Welcome to our 12th edition of Virtual Birdland. That was a composition co-written by myself and maestro Chucho Valdez, dedicated to the greatest musicians we knew, Bebo Valdez and Chico O'Farrill. The piece was entitled Bebo, Chico, Chucho, Duro, and it involved the participation of the great baritone saxophonist Larry Bustamante. Now, I want to tell you a little story before we go into our next piece. This is a bar. It used to be at 574 West End Avenue, apartment 2, where my mother and father lived for 54 years. And I saw many, many incredible musicians around this bar, possibly drinking this. Can't say. But they were there till all hours of the night, enjoying talking music. People like Dizzy Gillespie, people like Jerry Mulligan, Mario Bausa, hanging out and having a great time at this very bar at 574 West End Avenue. And that's just a little bit of insight into my life that I wanted to share with you. It's possible this next piece was written somewhere, either near this bar or actually at the bar, I don't know. But it's one of the great masterpieces of Chico O'Farrill's repertoire. This was written originally for Clark Terry and the Montreal Jazz Festival, but recorded by Dizzy Gillespie and Pablo Records, three Afro-Cuban jazz groups, but now it belongs to the one and only Jim Seeley. These are the three Afro-Cuban jazz moods.
Thank you.
the inimitable, indefatigable, my dear friend, Jim Seeley, playing the three Afro-Cuban jazz moods composed and arranged by Arturo Chico O'Farrill. Also featuring Alejandro Aviles and El Malcriado, Rafi Malquiel. This next piece is written to celebrate the birth of my friend Mary McCormick's grandson, commissioned by her and the Fund for the City of New York. It's a piece about fluidity and flexibility. Babies can go from crying their eyes out to laughing uproariously in the space of a second. And oh, that we were like that. Oh, that we could be that fluid and that easily brought to laughter. It seems hard these days. But remember the good times. Remember the joy. It's what holds us together. This is Baby Jack.
Thank you.
soloist, the great Alejandro Aviles on Baby Jack. We're going to continue now with, I want to tell you another story. I know I'm full of stories today, but I want to tell you about a gentleman who I loved and adored, and who was like a second father to me, Maggio Rivera, the great tenor saxophonist. A few people know that he also played trumpet and vibes and timbales, and he was really a musical genius. And the gentleman who's going to play the solo in this next piece is one of his mentees, and one of his great, great friends, and one of the greatest young tenor saxophonists in the world today. And so, in honor of Maggio Rivera, it gives me great pleasure to introduce Ivan Lenta playing Chico O'Farrill's arrangement of En la Oscuridad, which means in English, En la Oscuridad. Scudidat featuring the great Ivan Genta on the tenor saxophone. We're going to take a moment now and go to our pitch, which never ends because the demand never ends. this pandemic is still not over, and musicians and dancers and actors and stand-up comedians still are not working. They have no paycheck, they have no stability, and they're freaking out trying to figure out how to pay their rent, how to put food on their tables. And so, again, we turn to Keisel Jimenez and Joanna Elena for what has become an anthem of hope, an anthem of joy, reminding us this is our nuestro mundo. This is our world, and we're responsible for one another. So if you love this music, if you love the musicians who bring it to you, who selflessly spend their lives sacrificing so that they can become expert at what they do, to bring you this music, please consider giving to the Afro Latin Jazz Alliance Emergency Fund. We've reached over 150 young people and older folks with grants, and we're also in the midst of reaching our $100,000 goal. Please don't let them down. Remember to give back, to pay forward, to love those who've loved you for so long. This is a moment where we feature Nuestro Mundo.
En estos tiempos difíciles, el mundo está demandando empatía, comprensión, más amor. Únete para ser más fuerte.
Ven, no te rindas, únete. Mira que el mundo te necesita. Ven, no te rindas, únete. Mira que el mundo te necesita.
You know that love's in need of love today, and your support can help us defy.
By the way, this wasn't just a plug for donations. If you're a musician, if you're a freelance artist in New York City area and you're having trouble paying your bills, please reach out and apply to the Afro Latin Jazz Alliance Emergency Artists Fund and let us see if we can't help you. This next piece has a very strange title. The name of the piece is Haika Sose Baim Noone. And it's a Siri folk song from the indigenous Mexican people found along the northern Baja Mexico coast. And this is the arrangement, a brilliant arrangement by Adam O'Farrill. And we hope that you really enjoy it. Hay ka so se baim no one.
Thank you.
Set Bayim Noone featuring Jasper Dutz and Brian Davis. We have a great treat for you now. We have a special friend who wants to share something with you. Please watch.
Hello, my friends. This is Paquito de Rivera, and I want to invite you to join us with the wonderful Arturo O'Farrill and his Afro Latin Big Band in virtual Birdland, July 12th. virtual Birdland. Don't miss this event because it's going to be great. We're going to do some Brazilian stuff. See you there.
Yes, you heard correctly. Next week, our guest is none other than someone I've known for as long as I can remember, who's been a friend to our family and to jazz forever. How about a hand for Mr. Paquito de Rivera? You don't want to miss this. Before I introduce the final tune, there are some folks that need to be thanked. We need to thank our great trumpet soloist and lead videographer, Brian Davis, ably assisted by Astrid Asmundsen. We want to thank also our chief mixologist, Peter Carr. Peter Carr keeps this music sounding slamming, as they say in jazz. We want to thank the Afro Latin Jazz Alliance, Marietta Ulacia, Andrea Thompson, Gina Soto, who prepares these charts every week for us to be able to read them. We also want to thank Johnny Valente. A lot of people don't know that Johnny Valente has been supporting Afro Latin Jazz for longer than any institution alive. When he was on 104th Street, and then after 9/11, a lot of people don't know, when there was no one in the clubs, Johnny kept the band on stage every Sunday and kept the band, kept the club open no matter what. We thank you, Johnny. Those things are not lost on us. We thank you for your love and your perseverance. We also thank the staff, James and Santito Santos, all the people that work in the back of the house and in the front of the house to keep Birdland humming. You guys are the ones that make us look good. We also, of course, want to thank the mighty Afro Latin Jazz Orchestra, our saxophone section, Alejandro Aviles, Addison Evans, Roman Filiu, Ivan Lenta, Jasper Dutz, Jeremy Powell, and Larry Bustamante. We want to thank our trumpets, Seneca Black, Jim Seeley, Brian Davis, Adam O'Farrill, Rachel Therrien, Kai Sandoval, and Walter Cano. We want to thank our trombones, Rafi Malkiel, Mario Bilston, Abdul Rahman Amir, Ben Barnett, Earl McIntyre, and James Rogers. In the center of it all, the great Vince Chirico playing drums, assisted by Bam 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 Rodriguez, Carly Carlos Maldonado, and Casey Jimenez, and me, your host, Arturo O'Farrill, on the piano. We also want to thank our assistant musical director, Adam O'Farrill, who puts together these charts in a very concise way so that we all are able to end and start at the same time. One more thing I want to say, I want to get this off my chest in a way without sounding aggressive, but what's up with you, man? Why are you going outside without a mask on? Why are you eating at a restaurant without a mask on? What's wrong with you? Stop it. All the scientists, every single one of them, are telling us that this disease is spiking. Don't listen to the knucklehead in Washington. Do the right thing, man. If you're going to go outside, put on a fashionable looking mask like this and just say, "Bye-ya!"
Thank you for joining us. We hope you can tune in next week. Till then, good night.